بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله continuing on in our study of Imam Muqbil Bin Hadi Al-Wadi'i الله يرحمه his treatise هذه دعوتنا وعقيدتنا this is our call and this is our creed. We reached the portion of the treatise where Imam Muqbil, rahmatullahi alayhi, where he said, وَنَبْرَأَ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ دَعْوَاتِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ The Imam said, and we seek refuge in Allah from the call of ignorance, of the days of ignorance. أَحَبَتِ فِي اللَّهِ Imam Muqbil was referring to here that the mu'min follows kitabillah wa sunnatu rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the understanding of the salaf of this ummah and that all the other calls are calls which detract from that call. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, as it was mentioned on the Prophet ﷺ, that they said, خَطَّ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ خَطْ The Prophet ﷺ, he drew a line in the sand. ثُمَّ خَطَّ عَلَى يَمِينِهِ وَخَطَّ عَلَى يَسَارِهِ Then he drew on the right and the left. Actually, in the hadith, خَطَّ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ خَطْ ثُمَّ قَالْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلَ اللَّهِ The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that this is the path of Allah. This path, this straight path. سَبِيل Oops. سَبِيل اللَّهِ This is the سَبِيل اللَّهِ. This is the straight path. This is صِرَاطُ مُسْتَقِيم. ثُمَّ خَطَّ عَلَى يَمِينِهِ on the right. وَعَلَى يَسَارِهِ وَقَالْ هَذِهِ السُّبُلْ And he said that these are the subul. Those are the subul. عَلَى كُلِّ رَاسِ فِي شَيْطَانِ يَدْعُوا إِلَيْهِ Or كَمَا قَالَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ He said at every point on this path is a shaitan that is calling to that path. It's calling to this subul, or this sabil which goes away from sabil Allah, the sirat al-mustaqim. So I think it's understood, and the meaning of the hadith is showing us that we're to be one ummah. And that when we call to other groups and sects, and you say, I take bay'ah to my imam, I take bay'ah to, I'm a marid of Sheikh so-and-so, I have bay'ah to Sheikh Nasser Naqshbandi, and I'm adherent to the Brailoi madhab, or what have you, then all of these you are dividing from the Siratullahi Mustaqeem, from the Sabeel Allah that the Prophet ﷺ said. Because this Sabeel is one and it's straight. How do we know this? How do we know that Islam does not accommodate all of these paths? Because Nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, after he khatta lana rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khat, thumma qal, hadha sabeelullah. He said, that is the sabeelullah. He let us know that that path is narrow and it's straight. Then when you go and you say your jama'at tabliq, akhwan al-muslimin, jama'at takfir wa hijra, ISIS, now you're Boko Haram, this one is with Al-Shabaab. When you go and divide from all of these, you go away from the Sabeel Allah. The Siratullahi Mustaqeem. That straight path, which is from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, وَاتَّسِمُوا بِهَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَقُوا Hold on, all of you steadfast to the rope of Allah, and do not divide. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Iftarakat al-Yahuda la 72 firqa, wa iftarakat al-Nasara la 72 firqa, وستفترق هذه أمّة ثلاثة وسبعين فرقة كلها في النار الواحدة. قلنا من هي يا رسول الله؟ قال من كان على مثل ما كان عليه وصحابي. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم said, the Jews will break into 71 sects, and the Christians into 72 sects. And my nation, the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, will break into 73 sects, all of them in the fire. All of them in the hellfire. Except one. Illa wahida. Except one sect will not be in the fire. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, with their hirs al-ilm, their adherence and their desires to be better believers in Allah and to want to know more knowledge, ilm al-nafi, beneficial knowledge, and how to protect themselves from the hellfire and to get to Jannah, they would ask questions. That's why they said, Man hi ya Rasulullah, who are they, ya Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, those who are upon what I'm upon and my companions. وَكَمَا قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So this one saved sect, this is why they say فِرْقَةَ النَّاجِيَةَ, the saved sect, meaning saved from the hellfire. Doesn't mean every ifrad, every person in there is saved from the fire. It means from splitting up and not going into the fire. But that possibly, because other sins that a person may do, they could be from the major sins and whatever, you know, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But as a group, they are taking the correct path. They're on the da'wah to Ahl Sunnah. They're following the minhaj of the Salaf of this Ummah. They're on the Siratullahi Mustaqeem. They went on the straight path. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another Sahih Hadith, which is mashhur, قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم أُسِيكُم بِتَقُوَ اللَّهِ وَسَمْعِ وَطَاعَ وَإِنْ عَبْدٍ هَبَشِيًّا فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِيشْ مِنْكُمْ بَعْدِي فَسَيْرَى اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةِ خُلَفَاءِ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ الرَّاشِدِينَ تَمَسِكُوا بِهَا وَأَذُوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْتَثَلَ الْأُمُورِ فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. This hadith is azim, and this hadith is showing the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ, and that the ummah is to be one. The Prophet ﷺ said in this hadith, أُوْسِيكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. First he said, I advise you, or I order you with fearing Allah, adhering to the commandments of Allah and avoiding His prohibitions. وَسَمْعِ وَطَاعَ, and hearing and obeying the Muslim authorities. That's why we're not with Jamaat al-Takfir. That's why we're not with ISIS and ISIL and IS and Boko Haram and all these other takfiri groups that make takfir of all the Muslim nations. Matter of fact, they say that they're the only Muslim country. Where has this come? This is new in the history of Islam, except for their predecessors of the Khawarij. So, as-sam'i wa ta'ah. وَإِنْ عَبْدٍ هَبَشِيًّا. Even if it was an Ethiopian slave, because in their society, the slave, of course, was the lowest, as in any society that had this practice of slavery, that they viewed the slave, of course, as the lowest member of society. But Islam shows us that even this slave can rise to a place of leadership. That although, and not remain a slave, of course, but that he could have come from this origin, come from slavery, and be raised up. That this means nothing in the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the light of Islam. And that brings up another important point, ahabatifillah, regarding what the Shaykh said, rahmatullahi alayhi, when he said, وَنَبْرَ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ دَعْوَاتِ جَاهِلِيَّةِ. He said, and we seek refuge in Allah from the da'wat, from the calls, from the claims of jahiliyyah. Because Islam does also, along with this hizbiyah that we've been refuting here, and we've been talking about and discussing, that Islam is free from, because Allah wa Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited those things and said, وَاَعْتَسِلُوا بِهَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِعِينَ وَلَا تَفَرْقُوا, adhere all of you to steadfast in the rope of Allah and do not divide. The Prophet ﷺ said, as we mentioned this, the hadith of iftiraq, and many, many nasools, and we just mentioned in this hadith, the very hadith we're discussing. So there's two benefits in this point. Is that also a part of that call of jahiliyyah, of ignorance, is racism and arrogance. So if you think because you're Arab, you're better than anyone, you're going against the Nasus of Kitabina wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you think you're better than someone because you're white, you're going against the Nasus of Kitabina wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you think because you're African American or you're black, then you're better, you're going against Kitabina wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we don't have time for you. We don't have time for your da'wah. We don't have time for your call. And likewise, ahabatifillah, I want to mention this, because although everyone, all the Muslims, or most of the Muslims would agree to that, because if they don't, they would be outright going against the Nasus and knowing that they're in something wicked and sinful, and they're calling to something of jahiliyyah and ignorance. But what do we practice? What do we practice in our lands, all around the world? In many of the Arab countries, we already know the hierarchy between fair skin and darker skin. And we see all the time, and the issues of marriage. I once asked, and this is a true story, I was in a particular place here in Saudi Arabia, and it's a place where it's very tribal, very conservative place. And I asked this individual who had a high status, he was the acting head of the university. And we were discussing, and he asked me about racism in America. And I said, in Arabic to him, I said, Wallahi, I said, I haven't seen more racism compared to what I've seen here in Saudi Arabia. And he said to me, what? He was so shocked. I said, let me put it this way. If our brothers from Bangladesh, one of our brothers from Ahl Sunnah, beautiful beard, he practiced the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ali Kitabina wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alaihi, he wanted to marry from your tribe, how would you look at that? No. I said, but if a fasik, one who doesn't pray, who's not maybe not even Muslim anymore, he has nothing left of Islam except for his name and his heritage, drinks wine, zina, this, that, all the major sins, and doesn't maybe not even believe in Islam anymore, but he could have one of his girls because they're from the same tribe, they have the same color, they're the same region, whatever. That's the point of habitatullah. So Islam tells us to destroy that. Yes, we have distinct, unique backgrounds, we have distinct, unique cultures, but that doesn't overrun the scale of Islam. So watch it. Also, I hear some of these du'at, they ridicule the indigenous Muslims of America, primarily the African Americans. They try to belittle them when they immigrated to that land, made hijrah, or their forefathers did, not realizing the struggle that those people put in so that they can have a safer place. They're the ones who made those communities safe for you to walk in as a Muslim. So we have to watch this evil of thinking that you're better than someone because of their race, but judge by Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and get away from the da'wah to jahiliyyah. So in that hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَسَمِعْ مُطَاعٍ وَإِنْ عَبْدٍ هَبَشِيٍ فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِيشْ مِنْكُمْ بَعْدِي فَسَيَرَىٰ اخْتَلَافٍ كَثِيرًا. For the ones who lives after me, so we'll see many differences as we see now. Now we're just getting more and more fragmented as a community, and with the world changing and all the differences and all the conflicts and people with different ideologies in Islam, or who claim to be Muslim even, and all kind of things going on. The Prophet ﷺ didn't give us a prescription. So then it's upon you, my sunnah, and the sunnah of the rightly guided Khalifa. And then he said, Adu, he said, cling to it with your molar teeth. Be nawajid, wa iyyakum muhtathat al-umur, and beware of newly invented matters. Fa inna kulla bid'atin dalala. Every bid'ah, the Prophet ﷺ said, is misguidance. Wa kulla bid'atin dalala, wa kulla dalalatin fi an-nar. And every misguidance leads to the fire. Again, going back to here. That's not where we want to go. So avoid hizbiyah, calling to a group, calling to your crew, calling to the few brothers that you associate with. Avoid distancing yourself from the rest of the Muslims. Avoid attacking the honor of the rest of the Muslims and thinking that you and your little clique is saved. We have to be very cautious. Sometimes some of the biggest claimers, they want to defend the Sunnah. They have a good intention, but they're pointing their finger at everyone. Mubtadi'ah, 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 mubtadi'ah. And why they're pointing with their index finger, three fingers are going right back to them as far as their actions. Why? If you don't hold this position against this individual, you're from Ahl Bid'ah. If you don't get down with us and give lectures in our crew, with our masjid and our circuit of masajid, you're from Ahl Bid'ah. Where does this come from? How does this conform to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ and the madhab of the Salaf of this Ummah? That's what we want to know. Because that goes against, and that goes back to that dawah to jahiliyah, the dawah to hizbiyah. That goes to that dawah. Who in the world wants to be going on the subul, thinking that they're on the siratullahi mustaqim? That's a very dangerous thing, and that's the dawah to jahiliyah. And Imam Muqbil was severe against the hizbis and those people who called to themselves. And I love that great Imam, Allah yarhamhu, and may Allah forgive him for his mistakes he made. Imam, because his humbleness and his love for Kitabullah wa Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam helped him to have just a type of insight that you rarely see. You don't see that often from some younger mashayikh or something, not on that level. And also his environment, humble, and he dealt with hizbiyah, but he generally kept it on a balance scale. And you can listen on some of his tapes and you'll hear him say, Wallahi, we don't call you to come to us here and demand that this is, as if this is the only place, or this is, you know, calling to us, but we call you to Kitabullah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be upon that path. He didn't care. As long as you adhere to Kitabullah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the madhab of the Salaf of this Ummah, then he didn't care. It didn't have to be about him. It didn't have to be about the Salafis in Yemen. But it had to be about being Salafi, being from Ahl Sunnah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us of our many sins and our many mistakes. And we'll end off with one last hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the Muhajirin wa Ansar, they were arguing, and they said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَبِي دَعْوَةَ جَاهِلِيَّةَ وَأَنَا بَيْنَ أَذْهُرُكُمْ دَعْوَهَا فَإِنَّهَا مَنْتَنَا. The Prophet ﷺ said, when they were arguing between, because they said, O Muhajirin, O Ansar, the Prophet ﷺ corrected them, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and he said, are you calling to the ways of jahiliyyah, and I'm with you, I'm still alive between you, in your midst? He said, leave it, for verily it is wretched, letting us know the dawah to hizbiyah, the dawah to racism, the dawah to whatever, to try to supersede Islam, will not benefit you. And it's wretched. And it's the dawah to jahiliyyah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us of our many sins. Anything I said was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jal. Anything I said was incorrect was from myself and the shaytan, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.